the Tour Inline Hockey Arena in Colorado Springs, Colorado. This is the National Collegiate Roller Hockey Association National Championship Tournament. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Bill Cortland, the voice of the NCRHA, and working with me is college MVP and USA Hockey inline national team member Brian Yingling. Brian, today the Division I National Championship between the Lindenwood Lions and the University of Missouri at St. Louis Tritons.
Yeah, I'm expecting a great game here. This is what these kids came here for, to play for a national championship, Division I National Championship, so be it. The interesting fact of this game is that Lindenwood has been undefeated all year except for one blemish on the record, and that came at the hands of University of Missouri St. Louis. They beat them in their league playoff game, so they're going to be using that as to hopefully have some momentum coming into this national championship game.
Now, Lindenwood went through pool play 3-0, crushing their opponents. They've been beating up everybody during the playoffs, and this is the one team that they lost to back in their home region tournament. So you're right, this is the momentum for the motivator for them, and they are looking to claim another national championship with a victory today.
Oh, definitely. Anything less than national championship, and Lindenwood will be disappointed. It is the premier program for college roller hockey that everyone wants to strive to be and try to beat also. But UMSL did beat them in the playoffs, in their league playoffs, so they're going to use that to their advantage, try to come in with some momentum and knock Lindenwood off the top.
Should be quite a battle. This Division I National Championship game here on CET. National Championship game here at the National Collegiate Roller Hockey Association Championship Tournament. We are underway, the Lindenwood Lions and the University of Missouri at St. Louis Tritons. The Lions 18-0. And their only loss of the season, they're 18-0 in the regular season, their only loss this year was to this UMSL squad in the regional playoffs.
Yeah, definitely.
Regional championship.
And UMSL's got to be happy about that. Use that. Uh-oh.
There's a quick steal. A shot. Save. Oh. A steal by Kyle Gouge, who had 50 points for Lindenwood during the regular season.
And it looks like they got UMSL on a penalty. They're going to go to the box. A little hooking call, I believe. This official signals a hooking call. That's right. Number 12, Ben Lambert's going to the box here for UMSL. And Lindenwood's going to go into power play right away.
Oh, boy. Well, 30 seconds in. And 2 minutes is up on the board against UMSL.
And that's not the kind of start that UMSL wanted, putting Lindenwood on a power play right away.
All right, the puck taken by the shorthanded Tritons, and they ice the puck. Now, if you're new to inline hockey, we play three 12-minute stop time periods. There's no blue lines, there's no offsides, no icing. 4-on-4 normally, but with a man in the box, it's now a 4-on-3 power play. You see lots of available open space out there for everybody to operate. Tomy Bruce is the point man. He has the puck, playing a little catch back over here with Jeff Hill, who's in the right circle with the puck now. Slides it down to the goal line, back to Hill. He winds, he shoots, and the rebound came out. Ames made the initial save loose, and it's going to be taken by the shorthanded Tritons. They're going to skate it up and then play a safety back into their own end. Clever play by P.J.
Yep.
Tallow.
Yeah, great
and now
play
his teammates get the puck and clear it the length of the court.
Great play there by Tallow, trying to kill the clock a little bit.
We play with two referees. There is obviously no need for a linesman without offsides or icing. And again, the Lions set it up on the perimeter. 1 minute exactly to go on the man advantage. Minute and a half gone in the contest. And a goal. A big cannon shot from up high by number 22, Tomy Bruce. The power play goal for Lindenwood gives them an early 1-0 lead.
Wow, big shot there from the point coming from Bruce. Getting a pass from Jeff Hill. Pass it back up top to him, and one-timer off the post and in. And Bruce had a huge game in a semifinal game where Lindenwood beat UCI by a score of 11-4. Bruce had 3 goals in that game, picking up where he left off there.
Power play goal, and I believe the assist is going to go to Hill. We'll have to wait for the announcement there. I have a hard enough time paying attention to when somebody scores a goal. Here's the announcement. It is Hill with the assist. Bruce with the power play goal with 10:22 left in the first period. We just had another wrister on target from the left circle by Lindenwood, forcing a faceoff deep in the UMSL zone. Left circle draw. Jumped on by the Lions. They're going to dipsy-doodle and try to poke it to the right doorstep. Oh, boy. Player just out of reach. The puck just out of reach of a Lindenwood Lion player. That was Michael Thiefo. Now the Lions play a little catch back in their own end. Cantrell behind his own net.
Yeah, great start there by Lindenwood, and a start that UMSL did not want to have. Going to the box and giving up a power play goal.
There's a long shot in from above the left circle that goes wide and rims around. Well, as if Lindenwood, such a powerhouse squad, needed any motivation. This is the only team that they've lost to all year long.
Exactly.
And they jump out to this 1-0 lead. Shots on goal, 5-0 already, Lindenwood. So the Tritons without a shot on goal yet. Here's a walk-in from the right side. A wrister by Barnett. Goes up and out of play. He was trying to snipe it inside the right corner of the right post.
He almost had it, too. That puck had eyes there, just off the post and out. It looks like the official is saying it was deflected by the goaltender, so faceoff staying inside the zone.
All right, it's going to be Tom Mueller stepping in for the Lions. And who's he going to match up with? I think it's Adam Clark who's moving into the faceoff circle. A little quick discussion here between the officials.
I think they're talking about if the goaltender got a piece of that puck, which he did not, went off the post and out. Good job by the refs getting together, talking about it, making sure they dropped the puck where they're supposed to.
All right, so the faceoff, there is two faceoff dots halfway between the tops of the circles and the red line at center court. Red line, the only line on the court that counts. It refers to, it's used to determine a hand pass in the offensive zone. Mueller comes the other way for Lindenwood, gets around one defender, then a little poke check on the sidewall, takes it away. Puck is moved ahead to Holzem. He comes down the right side and is defended perfectly. Lindenwood with it again behind their own net. Just over 3 minutes into the contest. Now a long bounce pass taken in stride, moving in front. Oh, and Mueller just couldn't quite control it to get a shot. Back at half court, Mueller's going to get some help from a teammate. That was Tomy Bruce. Puck is played across. Barnett with it behind his own net. So many weapons on this Lindenwood squad. Puck over here to the right side to Gouge. He moves in. Got a shot. The save is made. Look at the goaltender. Ames is down and now back up. The rebound out to the point. Held in at the left side. Spinning away is Fudge from some pressure. Oh, and there's something you don't see every day. The puck was taken away from him. And it's thrown right away back to Barnett. He clears it down. Gouge will jump on it. He moves it up. Got a man in front. They got it to him. They're looking for a redirect. And Fudge with a clever couple of backhand tries, but a bouncing puck. He was unable to get any lumber on it. And it's taken by the Tritons. 4 minutes in. And still, the Tritons without an official shot on goal.
Yeah, Lindenwood has controlled this whole game so far. Obviously on the power play, getting a quick go on the power play. But even strength, they've controlled the puck the whole time.
All right, and the Tritons continue to hold the puck back there as they get a fresh pair of legs over the wall. Now, the outlet pass is not forthcoming, so they retreat.
And one thing Lindenwood does so well, the coach well by Ronnie Bielstein, but they play man-to-man, good man-to-man D. They stay with their men, and they're not letting UMSL break it out right now.
Well, there's a long home run pass, but it's out of the reach of Aaron Schultz. He tried to play it off the dasher board at the far end, but overskates. And the puck is right back to Lindenwood. Now they have it in their own end. Here's a home run pass. That is intercepted in half court. Nice play by Meade. Over to the right side, he moves the puck. They're in the right corner. Tried to throw it in front. Again, beautiful defense. And a shot out front deflected over to the side. Markell making some room for himself. Plays a safety back into his own right corner. Jumped on by the Tritons. They're cycling now along the perimeter. They throw the puck back out to the right point. A long blast through some traffic. Redirected. Whoa, stick save by Brown. Looked like he was leaning to the left and then spread eagle back out to the right, or did the splits back to the right.
Yeah, puck got deflected and kind of threw him off a little bit, but he was able to recover.
Perk, a long shot in. This one, a blocker save, goes up and out of play. And so Perk forces a faceoff deep in the Lions zone. And fresh skaters over the wall for both teams.
Yeah, early on, I think UMSL's strategy is to drop back in a little bit. It looks like a 1-3, actually. They're letting Lindenwood just come at them, and they're trying to keep everything to the outside, which is working so far, except for the one power play goal.
Left circle draw, drawn back to the top of the circle. The shot through traffic. Oh, it made it through the tangle of bodies and went outside along the surface, outside the right post. Now come the Lions back the other way. Sirigos gets a shot right on, a save by Ames, and he holds on.
Yeah, Ames will take that all day long. Nice little shot right into his chest. He'll eat that up all day long.
1-0, an early power play goal for Lindenwood from Tomy Bruce, assisted by Jeff Hill. Left circle drawn out deep in the Triton zone. It is jousted for, bouncing puck, kicked over here to the wall by the Lions. Sarigos will play it across. Whoops, a little mishandle there. Now he'll just hang on to it behind his own net.
And you can see Umsel just dropping back here, letting Lindenwood come right at him.
All right, McGinnis crossing over to the left side. He centered it in front, knocked away. Rebound try. Oh, fumbled. Rebound again. Puck loose in the slot, backhanded toward the net. That was wide. Is that Thifo with that opportunity? Now Sarigos tried to reach out and come up with a puck, but he couldn't. And Bruce ends up with it behind his own net. A little bit of sloppy passing by both teams here over the last couple of minutes. And now a pass over to the right circle. A wrister by Thifo, partially blocked. Tritons try to break. Pass out to half court. Lambert's going to go down alone, try to run some time off of the clock as his teammates change behind him. A couple of fresh skaters on for the Lions. There's a point shot from the top of the slot right on. Saved by Ames. Puck in the corner. Centered to the slot. Bouncing puck, though, and everybody gets bumped. And where's the puck? Back at half court now. Bruce plays it back to his team. Peeling back is going to be Danny Fry. And the Lions outlet pass here. Off the near wall. Moving down is Inouye. He moves in, shoots, and it's blocked by a stick and deflected up high. Now tipped ahead by the Tritons. They got a 2-on-2, and look at the defense. Solid once more for the Lions.
Just the speed of coming back forwards, coming back and helping the defensemen. They're not letting Umsel get anything going right now.
I mean, even with a step on them, they get back so fast and back check so well, nothing happened. All right, here come the Lions on the rush. A throw in, a save as the puck was deflected outside the left post. That bid by Gouge from the high slot. And the Lions will play a safety back to Kyle, back in his own end. Again, 50 points for Gouge during the regular season. Barnett with 56. Hill with 35, Bruce with 27. Here's a wrister from the left circle by the Lions. That's off the mark. A couple of players over skate. And a puck thrown out, and Inouye steps over there and claims it for the Lions at the red line. Oh. He's got a man moving up the right side, gets it to him. Here's Gouge down the right side, moves in, shoots, and missed it. Ah, tough break for Gouge. Yeah. Good thing for Ames. There was room inside that right post there over his shoulder, and that's where Gouge trying to put it.
Yeah, he had that top corner labeled. He just shot it over the net and went up out of play. But he just moved his feet, busted down the side of the rink, got a nice pass, and he was in all alone. Good speed there by Kyle Gouge.
And good pass by Inouye from cross court. Looks up and sees a teammate bursting out of his own end, and he throws a rink-wide pass to catch him in stride and send him in on goal. All right, we're inside 4 minutes to go here in the first period. Shots on goal, 11-2 in favor of Lindenwood. All right, now don't think they're gun-shy here, folks. This is very standard practice in inline hockey. Crisscrossing and waiting for outlet passes. And there's one now. Now a two-on-two developing. They got a man down low. Nice block out front on a pass across try by Holsom. And a turnover. Puck back to P.J. Tallow for the Tritons. He moves a pass ahead just out of reach. Sarigos reaches out with those long arms and knocks it aside. It comes to Hill. Lions will skate from their own end. And now they'll just play a little safety here while they put some fresh legs over the wall. There's bodies attached to those legs. All right, here they come. On the attack, moving into the slot is Hill with a wrister, and he scores. Wow. And the Lions lead it 2-0 with 3 minutes exactly to play in the first. Hill with a wicked wrist shot.
Yeah, nice shot there. And again, Umsel's just dropping back and letting Lindenwood come at him with full speed, and that's what happened there. Hill came up full speed, cut to the middle, got a nice wrist shot on net, squeaked through their arms, Ames there, and there's a two-goal lead here for Lindenwood.
I think you got to make a change in your strategy here to lay back and let these guys come at you.
I agree.
Crazy.
Yeah. Oh, there's a penalty coming up. Either a trip or a slash call coming up on Umsel here, and Lindenwood's going to go right back on the power play. So they pull the goalie for the extra attacker.
All right, I didn't see the penalty. What was it, a slash?
Or a trip, one or the other. Okay. Either or.
Oh, a hook or a trip or something like that. Okay.
Whatever he wants to call there, slashing or tripping.
So the Lindenwood goaltender is off. It's a 5-on-4 skating advantage here. Approaching 2.5 minutes to play in the first period, and for Lindenwood, they don't have to move the puck.
Not at all.
And no reason.
Here, some of the fans don't like it, but it's, to be honest with you, it's smart hockey right now.
Yeah, I mean, the onus is on the Tritons to do something here to make force Lindenwood to move the puck. They're in the offensive zone now. A big shot from the left circle is wide, and it rims out of the right corner all the way down. Again, the goaltender is out. It's a delayed penalty situation. Lindenwood with the puck. 2 minutes exactly to go here in the first. And when a goal is scored or St. Louis, Umsel touches the puck, the whistle will stop play and a penalty will be assessed unless, of course, the goal is scored.
At this point, Lindenwood would be happy with just killing the rest of the clock in this 5-on-4 if they can, so they have a full 2 minute, if they can't score, so they have a full 2 minute advantage here to start the second period.
There's a big blast from the high slot by Bruce. Might have got one of his own players in front. And staggering off to the side is Brandon Barnett. Is that Barnett? No, that was Gouge. Bruce moves it over to the right wing. Now he gets it back. He's at the high point. FIFO's over on the right circle. He got it. Throws it down low.
Yeah, good job by Lindenwood. Again, you can see how they're well-coached and disciplined. They're just controlling the puck, playing keep away from Umsel right now.
A minute 10 to go in the period, and we're still waiting for a puck to be touched by Umsel. And finally control and the touch of the puck by the Tritons. The whistle stops play, and it is a slashing minor coming up against Umsel with 1:01 left in the first period.
Yeah, this is a key penalty kill here for Umsel. If they go down by three, that's going to be a tall task to try to come back against this tough Lindenwood team. They want to do what they can and try to keep the play outside and don't let any passes through the middle and try to kill off this penalty.
It's Blake Propp who took the slashing minor. Inside the final minute of the play as we get back to action. Now a 4-on-3 skating advantage. 13-2 is the shots on goal. Look at the passing from the right circle. Hill's bid that time, though, was blocked right back to him. Around the perimeter they go. Bruce Wines shoots. That's blocked out front. And the puck is whistled the length of the court by the Tritons.
Yeah, great block there by Adam Clark. Tommy Bruce has a heavy shot from the top. They want to be careful. He scored the first goal with that shot from the top.
He'll move the puck over to the right circle. Now they give it back to him, to the left circle. Back to Bruce up top. Back and forth they go between the left circle. Now down to the goal line near the left post. Back to the circle, a one-timer slapped right on. Saved by Ames, and the puck is cleared.
Got 10 seconds here in the period. Lindenwood's going to make one more rush, try to get a goal before half.
Bruce throws it up to the left circle. That was Gouge with the bid. Back to Bruce, his shot blocked out front. 1 second, that'll do it. So the first period has come to an end, and for Umsel, not the kind of start they wanted. They take an early penalty that Bruce and friends convert into a goal. And at the end of one period of play, the Lindenwood Lions leading the University of Missouri at St. Louis Tritons 2-0. It's the NCRHA National Championship Tournament on CET. The Tour Inline Hockey Arena in Colorado Springs. A power play continuing now for the Lindenwood Lions. They are working it around the perimeter as Blake Propp continues to sit for the Tritons.
Looks like Lindenwood had a set play there to start the power play off, but Umsel almost deflected it to get a breakaway for themselves.
Tomy Bruce up top, slides it over to the right circle. Hill slides it down low. Teammates stick handling back there. They're trying to set up Gouge. Instead, they go to Bruce up high. Never a bad play to Gouge. Left circle. He slides in.
Oh,
shoots.
Wow.
Top shelf. Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
What a seeing
shot.
Eye shot there by
What a shot Gouge. By Kyle Gouge. There. Just working a puck around there. Moving around nice. Tomy Bruce makes a pass to Gouge, and he left no doubt. Put an upper glove right over Ames' shoulder. Make it 3-0. And just this has been a dominating game so far for Lindenwood, out shooting Umsel 15-2 at this point, up 3-0. It's going to be very hard, very difficult for Umsel to come back in this game.
3-0, two power play goals. So you can say clearly that Umsel has really hurt themselves here with the penalties. And to Lindenwood's credit, they have really taken advantage of the opportunities they've been given. There's a backhander in the slot by Andy Mead. That didn't work. Now he's tied up in the left corner.
Delayed call on Lindenwood. official signaling a tripping call. I don't know which player he's got, but a great chance here for Umsel to get back into this game.
So it's Gouge from Fudge and Bruce. And I believe we've got a Lindenwood penalty.
Yep,
it's going to be number 10, Tomy Mueller.
Got a tripping call. Took out one of the Umsel players, so they're going to have an opportunity to try to get within two goals here.
And if you're Lindenwood, that is not the play you want. You're on top. And, of course, I always say it's an easy game from the sidelines.
Yeah, of course.
But it is true. I mean, you look at the situation here, and if you're standing on the sidelines trying to coach the game or tell your players what to do, that'd be the first thing you tell them is, look, we're up 3-0. Don't take any dumb penalties. Let's keep the clock running. That's why they play the games. It's kids. There's a shot from the left circle, right on target by Prop, but sticked aside. Puck cleared back out front to Clark. To Prop, to Clark, to Prop, to Clark. Over to the right circle this time to Tallow. And again, they work it on the perimeter. Still a minute 25 to go on the man advantage. Tallow across the pattern. This time back to the point. A shot blocked out front. Beautiful defense. Clark has to play it across, and it is fumbled for a moment. Boy, the defenders charge at you at just the right moment. You better be as sure-handed a puck handler as you can be. Yep. There's a shot by Clark, again blocked out front. Tallow recovers.
Another good block there by Travis Fudge playing the top of the triangle.
Boy, he is taking a beating up top as the point man on the penalty kill.
Lindenwood doing an excellent job keeping everything to the outside, not letting Umsel come into the triangle at all, get any quality shots.
And again, every shooter has got a guy between him and the goal. Clark comes back the other way, shoots. The puck got through. Look out! As the puck was deflected up and onto our mezzanine.
A little too close to comfort for me. I don't know about you.
Well, so. I ducked.
Looks like the fans are right. I think he hit him in the hand and not the face. So.
Yeah, but he didn't make the catch. So he's out of here. All right. Now we're going to have, do we have a penalty coming up? No. The player knocked down.
Just mixing
and
it
it's
up
a Lindenwood player. Yep, mixing it up. There's a little bit of a scrum. It's dug loose. Clark throws it over to the left side. Still 25 seconds to go now on the power play. Clark has to recover near the right point. Slide it across. They got to get faster puck movement here, yeah, if you're going to get a good shot.
I agree. You want to try to get that moving around a little bit. Either that or just throw some pucks on net. They haven't had really any quality chances so far.
They're getting real gun-shy because of all of these shots that are blocked out front. I don't blame them, but you got to find a way to get in there. Now a tripping call coming up. Zarigos, I think, is the player who reached out there and hooked him down.
Good call, in my opinion, by the official. Zarigos was hustling. Player got by him, though, and he took him down, took away a scoring opportunity. So I'm so again going to go right back on the power play and see if they can generate any offense this time.
Now that, I'm not sure I would call that a bad penalty because,
exactly,
you know, he got beat positionally. That you can scream about that, but the guy pivoted around, beat him, and he was going off on his goaltender. Yep. I don't think that's a bad penalty to take.
Not at all. There are good, that's what coaches say all the time. Oh, here's a
break. Boy. Oh. Nice poke save there by the goaltender, Ames, but another break, shorthanded breakaway here. We've seen him in earlier games for Lindenwood. They just have so much speed to burn. A beautiful outlet pass.
I was just going to say that I don't think Umsel can keep up with their speed right now. Lindenwood is just skating by him right now, and I think the speed is just too much for Umsel to handle.
All right, we are back underway with a faceoff. Controlled by Umsel. They've got a minute 42 to go on their power play. 8:35 now to play in the second. 3-0 Lindenwood. And let's see if the Tritons can start pulling the trigger here. They do that time. A wrister is blocked. I think Bruce got hit with it.
Yep.
And then the puck is cleared out of the left corner.
But nothing is getting on net right now for Umsel. Lindenwood is just putting their bodies in front of every puck they throw at Dustin Brown.
Yeah, and assuming you beat all of these.
Oh
my! Ping pong pang, and the puck goes off of two defender skates and into the net. PJ Tallow threw the puck.
And who knows, maybe that's what they needed.
I mean, I always say it's a good play to throw the puck on net, but he wasn't even close to throwing it on net.
He was trying to go
across. He was throwing over to the left circle.
Yep, he was trying to go across rink to try to hit his teammate over there. Hit off two Lindenwood players, I believe, and in the net. So maybe that's what I'm so needed, you know, get on the board. Maybe hurt hurt Dustin Brown's confidence a little bit.
You know what they always say, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
That's exactly right. I live by that motto.
It's my personal motto, too. Although I'm usually not very lucky either. All right, play back underway. Puck is being turned over repeatedly by both teams. Everybody over skating. Now jumping up is going to be Bruce down the right side. He hammers one, and it goes off of, I think, the crossbar and up out of play.
Yeah, didn't miss by much there. Good shot there. Good shot by Tomy Bruce. Got to put that thing on net. I think he may have hit the outside of the net and off the boards and up out of play. So the faceoff's going to come outside.
Tallow the goal. Clark gets an assist. And really, you could credit an assist to a couple of unfortunate Lindenwood defenders.
Yep.
Back the other way, the puck is jousted for in the slot down low in front of Ames and goes off into the left corner. All right, now Tallow trying to work his way out of his own end. Outlet pass up ahead, broken up for the moment. Right back to Tallow. He starts to head up court. Stick handling, gets to the high slot. Fire, save, rebound is cleared back up. Tallow with it again. He's near the left point, now has to play a safety back into his own end.
Yeah, nice low hard shot there from the outside that almost squeaked through the legs.
Thompson holding it behind his own net for the Tritons. And later that same weekend, a hockey game broke out.
Yeah, and again, this is the discipline by Lindenwood, just finding a man and staying with him, really not letting Umsel have any momentum coming at him.
Not much of an outlet for them, so they give to Holsom, and he'll take up a spot behind his own net.
You know, when you play defense like this, you just have to be patient. Make the team try to force something. So that's what Lindenwood's trying to do right now. Just be patient and make Umsel try to force a long pass so they turn it over. Fans getting a little restless here.
I'm sorry, would you wake me when they move the ball? There we go. All right, Umsel comes out. There's an outlet pass to Meade from the left side. His shot blocked right back over to the sidewall. And an extra little push there. I think it was by FIFA. Now everybody overskates the puck. And out of the left right corner, who was that? Schultz tried to play it. Picked off by the Lions. They come out of their own left corner. They got a man ahead. It's a 2-on-1 down low. Bounce pass. Oh, good defense in front. Somebody got a stick on it. Then the bouncing puck is cleared all the way down. Boy, Lindenwood almost got themselves another one right there.
Yep, they had a great opportunity. That was an excellent defense, though, by Umsel. And a little different strategy. As you can see now, Umsel just drops back into kind of a 1-2-1, and they're letting Lindenwood come right at them, as in the other case, Lindenwood's staying with their men and not letting Umsel get any speed going.
And a backhanded bid toward the left post is on target, but Ames makes the stop and freezes it. You know, if this were the NHL with the positioning there, I'd call it a neutral zone trap.
Trap, exactly.
But there's not enough players out there, and there's not enough speed. I mean,
exactly.
Lindenwood is so fast, they can break through any trap attempt just with raw horsepower.
Yeah. It looks like Umsel is kind of setting up a trap, so to say, in roller hockey. But you're right, Lindenwood just keeps coming at him with all that speed. It's hard to do when you're standing flat-footed and you got a guy flying at you full speed.
They make one, kind of touch pass, and suddenly the guy's going 100 miles an hour. You can't catch him.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we are down to 5:15 to play in the second, so more than midway through the contest. Meade tries to move it. His pass was partially blocked. Puck up to center court. Oh, there's a tip ahead. The goaltender's got to come out. He's in no man's land, but he plays it. Backhanded off the glass and got himself out of position. And a throw on net by Kyle Dowd. Just like we saw in the earlier Lindenwood semifinal game.
That's right.
They're so opportunistic. And the goaltender put it off the glass. And this time, Gouge got to it. Wasn't it Bruce?
It was Tomy Bruce that did that in the semifinal.
And now Gouge says, watch, I can do the same thing.
Yeah, exactly. Ames did a good job of coming out and getting the puck, and he just played it up. And that, unfortunately for Ames, went right to Kyle Gouge. And he put it on net, and the Umsel defender tried to deflect it, almost blocked it, and got a piece of it, but not enough. And it goes in the net, and Lindenwood has a 3-goal lead, 5 minutes to go here in the second period.
And the tough thing to think about is you could just tuck it behind your own net, and nothing would happen. And you'd also remain close to in position to your own net.
There's another 2-on-1.
Uh-oh, here comes Lindenwood on the rush. Down the right side, they move in. A little drag play, shot, save. Oh, my goodness, good play there by John McGinnis. Getting a couple of shots. Now Sirigos plays it across and then heads for the net down the left side. They can't get a pass to him, so the Lions will retreat.
Yeah, nice patience there by McGinnis, just holding the puck and waiting and waiting and waiting and almost put it in on Ames. And we see McGinnis do that in the semifinal game against UCI. Same move.
FIFO with it behind his own net for the Lions. We're counting down to 4:15 to play in the second. 4-1 Lions. Shots on goal now. 19-7. Boy, the Lions came out for vengeance, and so far they are having their way here in this national championship game. The Tritons, the only team to defeat them this year, that was in their regional championship game. And the Lions really pouring it on here in the national championship. There's a loose puck at center, picked up by the Tritons. They move it over to the left side. Man snaps off a shot. Save is made by Brown. That's the thing, if you do get it through this defense, then you got an outstanding goaltender like Dustin Brown back there, who was 13-0 on the season, a .98 goals against average in the regular season, and a .897 save percentage. I mean, goodness, it's...
just dominating, and we talked about this before, they're just such a deep team. You know, they just, you know, they could put anybody out there on the floor and feel safe, and that's a nice thing to have for Coach Ron Bielstein.
Now look at Lindenwood, the guy, the kid is just playing toss off the back of the net to himself. We're down to 3:09 to play. All right, now the Lions will break. Whoops, somebody, a little bit of temper flare there. Bruce throws one in, looking for a deflection by Hill at the right post. That didn't work. Puck tipped ahead, and here's a rush for the Tritons. It is jousted away before an offensive threat develops. Schultz from the left side, a wrister goes wide. It rims around, it's picked up by Lindenwood. Here's another rush, 2-on-2. They throw it to the right side. Oh, it hit a defender's stick and caromed right back toward Ames. I don't know if he got a piece of it, but the puck went wide. Tallow picks it up, and he'll try to restore order behind his own net. Now he bursts around one man and heads up the left wall. Cuts over to the right side. Tried to slide it ahead to Prop. That's broken up. But Tallow has it once more at half court. 2:22 to play in the second. And again... a play from the, tipped on. Nice feed in front by Fudge. A redirection, I think that was that Gouge who redirected it?
I believe so. He cuts the net hard, and it was a great pass there by Travis Fudge hitting him in stride.
Ames was hugging the post, so that stopped the play as he made the stick save. 2 minutes to go in the second. Well, it has been all Lindenwood. Not particularly exciting, but very, very effective.
Yep, exactly. It's what they do. They play the game, they control the puck, and take advantage of any opportunities they get.
Sorigo's down the left side, fires a shot, deflects off a stick, and goes up into an overhead support.
Yeah, face-off here, I believe, to the right of Ames, as it was deflected off a UMSL player, maybe a little higher.
Well, we thought it was a great storyline to this contest that UMSL seemed to be the one team that was, you know, give the Lions a real challenge. They'd already beaten them once this year. And the Lions say, we're going to, go back to the old script here and keep on winning.
Yeah, it's just been a dominating performance so far by Lindenwood, proving why they are the premier program in the nation. And everybody wants to knock them off that peg, and everyone wants to strive to be like their program is.
They are the multiple national champions. They are the defending national champions. My goodness, they are talented and deep. Here's Scott back in his own end. We're down to 1-2-3 left in the second. And now we'll slow down the play a little bit. And look at the attackers come across. I mean, two men cut across, so Lindenwood running a little bit of a trap of their own. And from the right circle, a shot is blocked by the Tritons. And Sorigos muscles his way through, gets a shot from the right circle. That's deflected back around to the point. We'll see Danny Fry retreat behind his own net. Winding down to 45 seconds to go here in the second period. Move there, Barnett tried to get through a couple of people. That didn't work. Puck comes back to his teammates, though. Bruce behind his own net. 33 seconds to go. Break out the hammocks.
Yeah, maybe an opportunity here. They're going to save it. Maybe one last rush. Maybe 10 seconds to go, they're going to try to go down and get one last shot on goal.
All right, wake me when that happens, will you?
Uh-oh, here's a turnover.
There's a turnover. Schultz with it, and he can't get a shot. Jeremy Scott picks up the puck, turns, fires one. Easy glove save and a stoppage with 10.4 seconds left.
Yeah, that's an easy save for Dustin. I think I could have made that save.
But I'd have probably just fallen down into my own net.
But not a bad idea for Umsel, just putting the puck on net. You know, anything could happen. Try to get some traffic in front of Brown there and see if they can create some chances for themselves.
Yeah, but with a teammate in front, you want to put the shot low and force him to make a stick save. Now an outlet pass accelerating as McGinnis, he comes in, a shot save with 1 second left. And time runs out. Wow, there was that burst by Lindenwood. I mean, we wait and wait and wait.
And then it comes.
And then it comes. You know it's coming. It's like waiting for a tsunami. You don't see anything out over the calm ocean, and then a burst, and there it is. All right, we've reached the end of two periods of play, our Division I National Championship game here at the NCRHA National Championship Tournament. The Lindenwood Lions with a 4-1 lead over the University of Missouri at St. Louis Tritons. Underway with the third period of play. 12 minutes left. Either the Tritons get back in it here fast or the Lions are going to be the national champions. They have the puck and a 3-goal lead. And they're just going to promptly slow it down back in their own end after winning the opening faceoff.
Yeah, and Lindenwood is a well-coached, very disciplined team, so they're going to just rag this puck and control the clock and just eat that clock up. Umso may need to want to step up on these kids a little bit.
Here's a rush by Gouge. Comes through a couple of layers of defense. Got a shot. Saved. The rebound is in the right circle, but somebody's on their backhand. So smartly, they play a safety back. Clever play there by Jeff Hill. That's not a big play. Not going to impact the outcome of the game, but a smart play.
Smart play, exactly.
Illustrative of how well coached they are.
That's why they are who they are, because they do little things like that. They do little things very well.
Here's a little dipsy little move by Sirigos. He breaks to the left side. He's 1-on-4. Still manages to backhand one in deep. It's wide. Then he pops loose to Barnett. He walks in. A shot is blocked.
Good save by Ames.
Inouye was in there as well looking for a loose puck, but it's deflected up and out of play over the left corner.
I really like to see Elmsville start pressing just a little bit here. I know they're down 3 goals, 10:53 to go. You know, what's the difference if you lose 5-1, 6-1, 4-1? You know, loss is a loss at this point, so you want to try to get yourself back into the game any way you can.
Losing by one goal or losing by 10, it's still a loss. This is the national championship game. Throw it out on the table here.
That's right. Leave everything on the floor.
We got a delayed penalty coming up. Here's a drop pass to Schultz. He puts it over the right side, and now the penalty is going to be assessed after Brown makes a save. And puck touched by the Lions. Now the question is, what is the call?
It's a hooking call, and I don't know who they have here, who's the guilty player for Lindenwood.
Number 17 is Michael Inouye.
Yeah, he got guilty of hooking one of the Umsel players, and it's a great opportunity here to get back in this game, pull within two if they get a goal here in the power play.
This is just a huge, huge point in the contest here. And a pass across the slot, blocked by the defender. Nice play. Is that Fry with it?
I think that's Gouge.
Gouge, and then he ices the puck. Ahead to Tomy Bruce, who's behind the opposition net, and he is throwing it away at half court. All right, now Umsel with control. Here they come to the front court. Prop is over here on the left side. He gets the puck. Got a man over on the right side. They get it to him. But the defense is in the way. There's a shot through traffic. Save. Rebound. Cleared by the defense. Nice little backhand pitchfork by one of the deep defenders after Brown made a nice save.
Nice little shot on that. Umsel needs to get people crashing the net for rebounds and get traffic in front of Brown.
Still 1:05 to go on the man advantage. See, here's the challenge is they're just not able to move it around the perimeter fast enough. I'd give a nickel right now to see that, to go back in time and be present for that regional playoff, that regional championship game and see how that was done. Yeah, I'm not trying to be negative here, but this Umsel squad that's out here, the way they're playing today, it doesn't look like it's the same squad that could have possibly beaten this team.
Yeah, I agree with you.
There's Bruce from the right side. His shorthanded bid is blocked by Tallow. Clark steps in there to give some help. Now an outlet pass to the far wall. Out of reach. Meade picks it up, though.
just a little thing right there. They had a 3-on-2 opportunity, didn't make that outlet pass. So instead, they got to settle it down, set their power play up again.
All right, Meade slides it over to the right side. Now he gets it back. He winds and shoots, blocked over into the right corner. Dumped down low, but before Tallow can get there, it is played up to half court by the Lions. 8:39 to play. 3 seconds left on the man advantage, and they're just unable to get a lot of opportunities here. The Lions gain possession just as their man comes back on. Rink-wide pass by Fudge across. His teammate shoots. It's deflected up over the crossbar. It goes behind the net, and the puck is, what do we got, knocked out of the air with a high stick?
Yeah, well, either that or I think it hit the netting.
Oh.
Out of play, so the ref blows it dead. It looks like it's going to stay inside. You know, not much, you know, so just coming off the power play. Not many chances there they had on the power play.
And that was a big, big moment in the game. Again, something that, I mean, you'll see the penalty on the score sheet there, but you won't see how effective the Lions were, other than the fact that there's no entry, no goal, power play goal for UMSL. But, I mean, they just absolutely stuffed them. All right, here's a 2-on-2, a long shot in, sticked aside with disdain by Brown, off into the left corner.
It looks like UMSL's just happy just to throw the puck at the net and try to get a rebound.
Sarigos back the other way from the slot. A wrister goes over the crossbar and then up out of play. And I think that was touched by the goaltender.
Yeah, it was. Ames got a piece of that one, sent it off the glass and up out over into the netting. But Dustin Brown in net for Lindenwood. Any shots that he is getting on him, he's doing a good job of sticking aside. The lone goal he gave up was that ping pong or pinball goal that hit off about 5 different player skates of his own team. And then right in the net. Oh, there's a power.
Whoa, interference against Lindenwood's number 10, Tomy Mueller. And he says, who, me?
Dropping a puck there. He just took the guy out. Didn't even try to play the puck at all. He just went straight ahead and took the guy out. So good call by the official there. And once again, I'm still going on a power play, but let's see what they can do here. You know, sooner or later, you're going to expect Lindenwood maybe to capitalize on one of Humsel's power plays the way this game's been going.
Yeah, they had, I believe, was it 2 shorthanded goals in the semifinal win.
Yeah.
So they are fully capable of a shorty. And the puck is in possession of Lindenwood. Here is Gouge. A shorthanded bit goes wide and it rims all the way around. It could be a 2-on-1 now, a 3-on-2 developing from the right circle to the left side.
Oh,
shot.
Wow.
Oh, did that go in?
No. No, it was a great save.
They have a penalty. Okay, a slash.
Yep.
Oh, I thought the whistle was.
Nope.
Well, I thought the puck went in the back
of
the net and came right out.
Great save by Dustin Brown, side to side, making a great save. Lindenwood got guilty of a slash, and I don't know who they called there, but they're going to be down two men right now for a minute and 40 seconds. Looks like number 22, Tomy Bruce, goes to the box and sits down. And I didn't see the penalty. I didn't see that when I was watching the unbelievable save there by Dustin Brown, going side to side and just making a great blocker save.
I was watching the man shooting the puck from the right circle, and I thought it went into the twine and bounced right out. One referee was looking right at the net and saw the save made, as did you, and then the outside official made the penalty call. So it's a 4-on-2 for a minute and a half. Meade to the point man. Clark back to Meade, left circle. Back to Clark. Two defenders. There's a wrister that is partially deflected and wide. It comes out of the left corner to Meade. To Clark. To Meade. Over deflected away by a stick and over to the far wall. Back to Meade in the left circle. To Clark up top. To Meade in the left circle. To Clark. To Meade. A one-timer.
Oh,
score!
That's a nice goal.
That's a big, big goal. And they get 4-2 with 6:56 to play. Tons of time left.
Plus, they're still going to have a 4-on-3 for a minute and 19. But finally, they were passing around the perimeter, working around, and finally they took a one-timer. And I believe that actually deflected off of Kyle Gouge a little bit, too. Hit off maybe his shin guard and went into the net. So a little bit of a break there for UMSL, getting a deflection off the Lindenwood defenseman and into the net, make this a 4-2 game.
Well, honey, like hold the phone. Timeout. UMSL, they realize how critical this remaining penalty time is. They've got a power play for another minute 19. That'll be a 4-on-3 situation after they just scored on a 4-on-2.
Yeah, their 4-on-3 power play so far today hasn't really done much. So I'm sure they want to sit down right now, talk about things, talk things over, try to generate something so maybe they can get within one goal here on this power play.
Meade with the goal, and Clark got the primary assist. I'm not sure if there was a secondary assist on that power play either, but That is just a big, big goal to make it a two-goal game, 4-2 with 6:56 left to play.
Yeah, that was a nice shot. Nice shot there by Umsel. And they got to do a lot of the same here to finish out this power play. You know, a full minute 19, that's a lot of time. One minute 19 seconds, that's a lot of power play time left. So they got to do a good job here, try to get back within one here.
Much better puck movement. Now, there was obviously a lot more room with only two defenders out there. Interesting that the defenders are doing, I mean, they continue, whether it's two men or three men, they do such a great job of laying out their sticks.
Yep.
And Umsel, I don't think they've mastered the pancake, you know, flip pass or to get over the stick and land it onto the tape of the other guy.
Yeah,
I mean, that's a tremendous skill pass.
That's a tough pass to make.
Tough pass.
Saucer pass, try to sauce it over a guy. That's a tough pass to make.
But it's what Lindenwood is forcing them to have to do in order to get a shot during a 4-on-3. Now, there was more room and good puck movement on that 4-on-2. And that's my question is, what can they do now with a 4-on-3?
Yeah. I mean, the two goals they got have been deflections off of people. So I would see them trying to do a little bit of the same, maybe put two guys in front of Dustin Brown and just shoot from the point, try to get shots through to him.
And, folks, there has been only one even strength, I beg your pardon, there's been two even strength goals, one in the first and one in the second, both by Lindenwood. There's a long shot in and a fat
got
rebound.
A breakaway chance here.
Oh, my goodness, it's cleared ahead onto the stick of Fudge. He moves in on goal and scores!
Nice
made
move.
A quick move on Ames and then danced to the right and threw it in the net. And it's back to a three-goal lead. It's 5-2 with 6:35 left to play. A shorthanded goal for Lindenwood.
And Umsel did just what we talked about. They put the puck on net, but the rebound was there, but it went right to Sirigos, the Lindenwood player. And Travis Fudge just broke right away as soon as he saw him get to the puck and had a breakaway. Nice move and finished it.
Well, now it's a critical 50 seconds left on the power.
Oh, right back.
Oh, beautiful to the
right
post.
Back.
Great pass. Thompson, I believe, was the man at the right post. Well, I got to wait to see the number there, but a great throw in.
And that was P.J. Tallow that made that pass. Just an excellent pass. And I got to see who they give credit to that goal for, who that player was sitting there by the crease. May have been number 29 there, Eric Thompson, but that was an excellent pass by P.J. Tallow.
We just said they got to do something on this power play now with 50 seconds left. They promptly score the power play goal. It's back to a two-goal game, 5-3 with 6:18 to play.
And it was credited to Thompson.
Ames and Tallow with the assist, Thompson with the goal. See, I get one right every once in a while. We're inside 6 minutes to play. Umsel with the puck in their own zone. The Tritons flip it ahead. Tallow's got to chase it, but jumping on it to the Lions.
Uh-oh.
And they got a 3-on-1 if they hustle and turn into a 3-on-2. Drop pass to the trail man. Fry moves it over the right side. Save, follow-up try. Ames is over at the right porch to cover up.
Good opportunity there by Lindenwood on a 3-on-2. The puck kind of got up on him, was bouncing a little bit, so it wouldn't lay flat for them to get a good scoring chance.
Shots on goal, 26-15 for the contest, and a 5-3 Lindenwood lead. They have the 26 shots on goal. And now Umsel trying to work the puck out of their own end. They do. Down the right side, Adam Clark gets kind of wiped out there. Lindenwood plays it across. Here's their man bursting up the right side. It's Kyle Gouge. Pass over to the left side. Too long. Down in the left corner. They're trying to cycle it. Blocked. And look out. Don't want to walk out too close to your own net there. Here come the Tritons. Burt slides it ahead. Intended for Schultz. Back into the corner. Back up to the point man now. Perk with it. Throws it across. They're retreating back into their own end here. We're under 5 minutes to play.
Yeah, I'm still slowing it down a little bit, and there's no time to panic yet. They're still only down by two goals, but you know they may want to start every now and then taking a chance here.
All right, here they come out of their own end. Up the left side near wall. Tallow accelerates, gets around him. Backhand try, and a goaltender's looking for it, and we get a whistle. And the puck was smothered in the crease by Brown. He made the initial save and froze, and then apparently the puck dropped out of his sweater down at his feet.
Yeah.
And then he covered it, and the whistle sounded.
Nice speed there by P.J. Tallow, showing some speed going behind the net, picking the puck up and beating a Lindenwood defender, and almost shoved one short side there on Dustin Brown. That would have been a big goal there for UMSL.
We got a look there at P.J. Tallow. And the faceoff is going to be drawn back to the point man, Mead. He wrists it through traffic, kick save, rebound, right circle. Oh, ton of bodies in front as Prop tried to shove it through. And now a pass, kind of a semi-pass shot, is blocked. Again, the defenders block it with their stick.
Yeah, just putting their bodies in front of any puck they can.
It's Arrigos ended up with it, played a safety back, and now here's Fudge trying to burst through. Got it over to the left side. Arrigos tried to go back to him. That was blocked. Arrigos gets it back, carries behind the net, and gets roughed up. So we're going to have a penalty. I think he called Arrigos. Yeah. For a retaliation. I don't think Arrigos was retaliating.
No.
Somebody came in behind him, and he was skating backwards after being bumped and bumped that other guy inadvertently.
Yeah. I was just going to say, not a smart play there by UMSL player taking a penalty, but Arrigos took one himself.
They get bailed out on the call against Arrigos.
Well, let's see here. Yeah, he is taking the UMSL player. Okay, good. There's a little confusion on the floor right now. So it should be 4-on-4 hockey still for the last 4 minutes to go.
Well, there's certainly confusion up here in the booth.
But that's normal.
That's certainly my normal state of affairs. All right, for UMSL, it's Blake Prop who takes the penalty for them. And for Lindenwood, it's Nick Sirigo. So coincidental minor penalties. The teams will skate 4-on-4 still. And for Lindenwood, they've got the puck at center court. Here's Fudge turning, going into the slot, still stick handling. It's poked away from him, and a defenseman picks it up. Now they move it ahead. Mead trying to get his way around, can't get past. Who was that, Gouge again?
Yeah.
Wow, is he fast on his feet?
Yeah, he is. Good, strong, fast player.
Tomy Bruce takes it and heads up court. Ooh, look out. Somebody got a stick at him. Now a little poke check, and that is a clean steal from Tomy Bruce, not what you see every day. Here's Lambert down the left side. His shot blocked by a defender out front. Once again, the puck never gets through to the goaltender. And we're down to 3:15 left to play. McGinnis crisscrossing near the red line. Comes into the high slot. Stick handles. Gets around a man. Right circled. Steep angles. Bid is blocked. Back behind the net goes the puck.
He's going to bring it back. All the way back. Try to kill that clock.
And for the Tritons, they got to try to get possession here. Do whatever they can. You see how they come forward, and the guy just dances around him. Gouge moved it over to the right side. That play failed, and now we got a penalty.
Delayed call here against UMSL.
Boy, hooking is going to put them shorthanded again.
That may take the win out of the sails there. 2:48 to go. They're going to be shorthanded for pretty much the rest of this game here. Tough task to score two shorthanded goals against Lindenwood to tie it up. That's going to be tough for them to do. UMSL player not too happy about that call.
So if you're Lindenwood, do you want to put on the jets and then retreat behind your own net once more? Just don't take a penalty.
Yeah.
And
Either you want to, you know, try to go for a goal and really put this game away, or you just want to play keep away from them. Spread the floor out a little bit and play keep away from UMSL.
You play keep away for a couple of minutes here, and the trophy is yours.
Yep. Looks like that may be what they're doing, but we'll see. They may want to try to get another goal and really put the nail in the coffin.
And for UMSL, I mean, the hazard here, they're sitting back, but the hazard is without the puck, they can't win the game.
Yep.
They cannot win. And yet, I don't know, there are no moral victories. Lindenwood throws the puck back to their own net. So I would say you got to take chances here.
Yeah, I agree with you. You got to take some chances, and hopefully Ames comes up with some big saves.
See if you can get a long rebound and take off the other way, maybe catch a break, but laying back like this, they're just running the clock.
Yep.
There's only going to be 48 seconds left when the penalty time expires. Now here's a pass to Hill from the right side. He walks in, shoots.
Nice
glove save by Ames.
Nice patience by Hill. Even better save by Ames there, staying with him and catching the puck out of midair there with the glove.
1:48 left in the contest. Shots on goal, 28-19 in favor of Lindenwood. 5-3 is their lead. They still got a power play for another 59 seconds. Clean faceoff win back to Tomy Bruce at half court. And now they'll just slap the puck back down into their own zone. Here's a little bit of a foot race. Mead gets to it, carries it behind the opposition net. Two defenders slap it away from him.
And you can see Umsel stepping up a little bit, trying to pressure the puck a little bit, and that's what they have to do right now.
Yeah, you can see right away P.J. Tallow said, okay, I've got some wind back. Now we got to go. I'm sure these guys are gassed, too. Everybody's played a bunch of hockey here over the 4 days.
Yeah, there's a 3-on-1 chance.
There's Bruce. Everyone's
got to be careful that they don't miss the net and the puck goes the other way.
In deep, and a little wrist
pocket. Don't have to worry about that.
With 1:07 left to play, a power play goal for Lindenwood.
That should just about do it.
And that is really going to spell finesse here. I cannot see how Umsel can get themselves back from this 6-3 against the defending national champion.
No, you never want to say quit, but you know this is going to be very hard for them to come back here.
1 minute of play.
We've called those guys a lot. Gouge, Bruce, Hill. All three of them really stepped up and had a good game.
Now we're down to just about 30 seconds left. And again, Lindenwood will set up shop behind their own net. Tallow, with some half-hearted pressure, forces them out from behind their own net. And now the Lions will just cruise around. And the team is on its feet over across the way, pounding the sidewall with their sticks. The Lindenwood fans come to their feet. 10 seconds left.
That'll do it. Congratulations to Lindenwood.
The Tritons retreat. They've had themselves a whale of a season and a great tournament, but it's going to be the Lindenwood Lions who are the Division I national champions.
Yep. You know, it's always sweet. You see the kids are excited, but it's like they're used to it by now. You know, they're so used to winning a national championship. But congratulations, Lindenwood. An excellent game, dominating performance throughout the whole tournament. They were the team to beat, and they proved it. And it was just an excellent showing today.
And they did not lose a game throughout the tournament. Yep. Undefeated in pool play, and then they marched through the playoffs, dominating every opponent and finishing it off with a 6-3 win here in the national championship. So the teams will meet at center court for a post-game handshake. There's your national champions. The Lindenwood Lions win it in 2008. Thanks, everybody, for watching CET. Good night from the Tour Inline Hockey Arena. Tomy, 7-time national champions. Congratulations. Another Division I victory.
It feels great. I mean, this year it just gets better and better every year, so we're excited.
We keep calling you guys, your name a whole bunch during the game. You had another outstanding effort both in the semifinal this morning and in the championship game. Who do you want to say hi to?
Well, my dad's here, so I'm going to say hi to my mom at home, my girlfriend at home, her family, my family at home, my brothers. That's it.
Does it ever get old?
Absolutely not.
What year of college are you in?
I am a senior, but I'm returning next year again.
So you've won now three, you've been a part of three or four championship teams?
This is four. So I'm coming back for five next year.
How many players get to win five collegiate national champions?
I would have to say not many, so I'm excited about it.
I don't think anybody's ever done it before.
I don't know.
I don't even know of anybody that's done four in a row, so five is going to be absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah, I agree.
Your team now 7 times in a row. That is unbelievable. You're a sophomore, so you got to crack at two more titles before you're done, hopefully.
That's right. Yeah, hopefully, definitely.
You had another strong performance today, a great semifinal game this morning, and then a national championship victory over the only team that beat you this season. How sweet is that?
That's awesome. That's how we wanted it. Both of those teams, man, we're rivals. We love each other. We know each other. And it was just a great game. We couldn't ask for anything better than to play them in the finals of the national championship game and come out on top.